Hello and welcome to Fierce. This program celebrates the diversity of LGBTIQ identities and perspectives. Fierce is produced in Bundjalung country at 2NCR Lismore and can also be heard on podcast at fiercefm.podbean.com and in New Zealand on Fresh FM, as well as all over Australia through the Community Radio Network.
Fierce FM on Spotify and YouTube.
Slut! I'm hungry.
What are you hungry for, Bubba?
Meat.
I like to swallow, but I'm a vegetarian.
Well, tonight it's meat.
Well, I have been invited to the Kooked Queer show filming. They're making a vegetarian mushroom pasta.
Why have you been invited, not me?
Well, they're making a mushroom pasta and I'm a fun guy. One thing about Italian cooks, they know their pan has to be hot before they put their meat in.
Well, I'm hot.
Look. How does she look? Let's have a look. You are so beautiful. Yeah. Smiley. Although I've got to call you Hazelnuts now.
Yes. Just when we do the Kooked Queer cooking show, I am Hazelnuts. When I'm not like this, I am Smiley.
Where'd you come up with Hazelnuts?
Dylan's partner, Ivy, because she's been fantastically spotted on. When she said Hazelnuts, like, oh, and Hazelnuts always been my favorite ice cream when I was a kid. I was just eating Hazelnuts. Yes, and I used to pick the Hazelnuts, so my auntie, she always say, go and pick up some Hazelnuts. I feel that some people tell you that I'm nuts. Now I realize that I'm just unique and I'm just don't follow the whole crowd. You can call me nuts and I'm happy with that name. I love it if it's become with Hazel.
Oh, welcome to the Kooked Queer Cooking Show. My name is Hazel Nuts and I feel excited to prepare for risotto. You want to have a nice stock. You put celery and onion and carrots, and you more you splash it better.
Well, I've seen some of the shows on Facebook and I just witnessed live the last episode of season one. Very exciting. What an amazing achievement to put together a whole season of cooking shows. How did this all start?
Oh my God. I'm also a massage therapist. I was having a massage from my teacher and this thing came up. So she's got this amazing kitchen that looks like a TV show kitchen. And I felt like, this is it. I want to create a TV show. I want to help people and nature at the same time. So I have a plan to have this huge land of cow paddy and recreate a forest, healing center in the middle, and different villages like a Confest Festival that is happening in Australia, which is becoming inclusive. Instead of having one little village, you have different. So you go where you like it. And then, so is everyone is inclusive. You know, someone doesn't want to eat meat, that they go into a space where we don't eat meat, or a place that want to be quiet in the night, or anything that really. And then if you don't like any of the groups, it can open a new one. So the land needs to be big. And I thought, oh, then we're talking about a lot of money. We need a lot of people and people that knows about this project. How can we reach to all these people? And then COVID happened, and Adriana, that I'm living at her place, she did all this amazing support, and she said, now is the time, don't wait. We started like that, and then slowly, like, I'm so lucky because of our flatmates, the whole camera lights and everything, it looks more professional than what I was expecting.
Five cameras all around, one was roaming, and four were on tripods, and there was three lights.
Magic. My God. Slowly, we thought, why we don't go into different kitchen? Why we don't have different guests? And so I like to include different cultures in this show and different way of cooking and thinking or singing or doing things, you know, and sharing. I was a chef by trade. I saw that people were very sad in the restaurants cooking, and I say, oh my God, all that energy goes into the food. And I always used to have my own way, and people ask me, they love my food, everything for others and for myself. I mean, then I get everything back when it's like, oh my God, and I'm like, oh, I feel it. I want to pass it on, this message of cook with a beautiful energy of love and happiness, will actually heal people without judgment as well. Like, every performance to be queer. Do whatever you like, dress up whatever you feel, holding the space and having fun with it.
Fierce FM. Hi, I'm DJ Bigfoot.
And I'm DJ Magnus, and we're coming to you live on Fierce FM.
The greatest radio station in the northern world.
And the world. Fierce FM, yeah.
Krikor Manukyan by Greg is for the Aussies.
Thank you, because I can't repeat that. Okay, so you're a good friend of Smiley?
Yes. 9 years ago, I think, when we started working in hospitality, on my first shift, we met each other and we fell in love with each other. And then we just went partying together, we were working together as waiters, as chefs, as many industries. Until this project came up and I was in Sydney and he told me to create together. So we're on this now. We're doing the show. I'm doing the edit and the camera, the setup, the lighting, myself and a few more people as well, not just me. But with Smiley, it's a lot of fun. Every time it's a different costume, dress ups. We try to see what each episode has to give, which is like very unique, each one of them.
What is your vision for this show?
To spread the love, good energy, bring people together, cook together, enter people's houses, and then be familiar with each other. Get to meet more people like-minded, have fun, and learn.
And so you've come from Sydney. Have you been in Lismore long, and what do you think of it?
I've been in Lismore for a couple of months. I've been here before for tropical fruits a couple of times, and I love the northern rivers. I think it's like one of the most magical parts of Australia. I love it, especially at this moment that everything is like chaotic and the rest of the world is like burning down. In Lismore, everything's just growing. It's beautiful nature. And I hope I see you around.
Hi, I'm Emily Finch.
And I'm Janet Marshall.
And we love Fierce FM.
Woo! We're standing in the garden with John Miller.
Hi, everyone.
He's ex-ABC, now living at Adriana's house. What's it like going from the ABC and now be working with Smiley?
I've worked with a lot of different people over the years. Working with him's been a real pleasure. He never runs out of new ideas and we always come up with something. It's a real good collaborative effort.
And were you involved from the very beginning of the show and helping to make it happen?
Yes, I was. Working out the structure of the show, he had a pretty good idea, and we were able to work around any technical constraints he had.
Are you the director?
No, we don't have a director per se. The director really is Smiley, because he determines the structure and so on of the show. I'd probably call myself first assistant director in getting the shots and so on. It's been great being able to mentor Greg and Dylan as well. They're both knowledgeable young fellas who are going to make a real big impact, I think, on the industry over the years. And it's just the way to do it. Start off with things like this and keep going.
You've made the big move from Sydney to Lismore.
I've got quite a few friends up here, a lot of industry friends. This seems to be a bit of an ABC retirement village up in the Northern Rivers. We've got about 14 of us who live up here. So we could just about start our own mini ABC.
Hi, this is Stephen Hawkins, and you're listening to Fierce, the best radio show in the world.
When I was smaller and people were taller, I realized that I was different. I had a power that set me apart. I learned to take it, to use it, to make it. It's not so bad to be different, to do your own thing and do it with heart. Different is hard. First I'd wonder what hex I was under. What did I do to be so different? Then I discovered some others like me. Wonder no longer, together we're stronger. It's not so bad to be different. Be true to yourself, that's what you must be. Different is hard, different is lonely.
Foxy, tell me.
Well, I perform a lot in my living room, by myself, with no one watching. I usually perform for tropical fruits, incredible fairies, private parties.
We're behind the scenes with Foxy.
Oh my God, hi.
And how's lockdown been for you?
I still had to go to work, so nothing really changed there. I guess the biggest thing that changed was my time to chill is to go swimming. And the pool that I go to, it's shut. And the other thing is, you know, I couldn't perform anywhere. So being able to do things like the Kooked Queer cooking show with hazelnuts. I did a photo shoot last weekend with Brad Musto, who's a fabulous photographer for Tropical Fruits, Lismore. And next weekend, Foxy's got a date with Humans of Lismore. So she's going to do a photo shoot and interview about Foxy. And now that places have returned, bars and dance spaces, I don't really want to perform for like a small crowd. I kind of want to wait just for everything to go back to whatever normal is, you know, and like have people actually enjoy my performances.
I think I was there the very first performance you did.
5 years ago, and it was for Tropical Fruits. And I did the soiree party, and then I did the New Year's Eve cabaret for Tropical Fruits that year as well. And that was so exciting. Kind of got my start. I bought a vintage woman's bathing suit. I shaved my legs. I shaved my armpits. I was shaving everywhere. I had a cute little wig on. You know, hadn't done makeup before, so I did my makeup. I gave it a whirl, and I got so much love from that performance. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to keep going with this because I think I can do it.
So 5 years isn't long. And so have you found you've come out of your shell as your alter ego?
I've found, not so much out of my shell, but what I have found is that I'm being more creative. Like, I loved this, so I knew that I was doing the show today, so I wanted to do a headpiece because I wasn't a big fan of my wig. I tried for a couple of hours to do an updo with my wig. It looked terrible. So I thought, okay, the only way I can disguise this wig was to make a headpiece. So I made this yesterday. I don't know if you can see the sparkles on it, but I do love this. And I think it just makes the whole piece. I'm into it. Yeah, so I'm really enjoying the creative aspect. But I guess the thing that I'm most excited about is that I've just worked out how to put on makeup well. Because before I was watching YouTube tutorials and, you know, going through the motions, but now I've actually figured out my own way of doing my makeup and I feel pretty. I think most makeup artists would say the trick to makeup is to blend. It's true, but also have good tools for your makeup. Detailed small brushes to do detailed work and have the larger fluffy brushes, you know, to do bigger work. Yeah, so have good tools, I think.
Can we do a close-up on your eyelashes that you made?
I don't think they're particularly great, but Peter seems to like them.
Gotta be big. Gotta be big.
They're big, yeah.
You've grown up in this community as a drag queen for 5 years.
Yes.
And you haven't been to the Big Smoke. So do you think you might venture away from here?
Interesting you ask. So I do know of a couple of drag queens up in Brisbane, and I've put my name down to perform up there. So we'll just see what happens. Once the Queensland border opens, I'm looking forward to performing in a club, actually. My God, one in the morning, though. That'd be weird because I go to bed quite early. I'm a early to bed, early riser. So like I was up at 5 this morning to do my makeup because I had to be here by 11. I gave myself 5 hours this morning. That was to get up, have breakfast, shave, do my makeup and then get ready. If I give myself more time, it's more relaxing for me because I want this experience to be enjoyable and I don't want to really stress out about it or, you know, feel anxious about it. So by getting up a bit earlier, I just have that peace of mind that I can get everything done within the time I've given myself.
Were you always wanting to be a drag queen? Were you watching drag queens and thinking, you know what I mean? Like,
Yeah. RuPaul is large. I mean, that's huge, that show. I love watching drag queens. When I was younger, I didn't really understand drag queens. But now that I'm older, I can see the creative outlet, especially that I'm experiencing. Maud Boat, she's an iconic Lismore drag queen. She's so incredible. She's so talented. Her makeup, her costumes especially. She inspired me to get into drag. And first time I got into drag, she was actually hosting a night where I live, another local drag queen. And I saw them both perform, and I saw this other drag queen perform, and she wasn't as good as Maud, and I thought, I can do that too. And so that night, I actually won, first night like, I was dressed up in drag, like really cheap looking, but I thought it looked great. And I won best dress that night, and actually Maud whispered in my ear, she said, stunning. That made my night, and that actually gave a boost in my confidence. And I thought, my God, this really put together drag queen, it's complimenting me, who looks probably crap, but is feeling, you know, is feeling herself. If she can pay me a compliment like that, then I think maybe I do have something.
Oh, that's beautiful. So any tips for newbies that might be considering getting dressed up and dancing?
Oh my gosh, yes. First of all, you've got to enjoy it. Learn your craft. Watch drag queens perform. Watch YouTube tutorials about, you know, how to do drag makeup. Like, learn, you know, and then get artsy and crafty. Learn how to do your headpieces or make your own earrings. Get creative. And I think that's the beauty of drag. You can be your own unique expression of yourself through your creativity and through your art.
I like to come in your kitchens.
I can come to you and...
You can come to me anytime. Foxy's Facebook page, on Instagram, performances on YouTube.
Yes!
At Foxy Brown-Eye. All one word.
Fantastic!
Hey guys, this is Ray Isaac, the DJ from Madonna Bar, and you're listening to the amazing Fierce FM.
This is Adriana's son, Dylan mcConville.
Mm-hmm. It's on the show.
You live here, I guess, so that's how you got involved.
Yeah, so Smiley moved in with me and my mother and a housemate, and he brought the queer cooking show with him. And I've actually done my screen and media courses at TAFE, and I've filmed a few short movies now. I felt obligated to be part of the show, yeah.
What's it like living with Smiley?
Living with Smiley, the cooked queer, it's quite extravagant. It's this intense queer gardener, chef, and everything community, and he brings a really unique energy to this place, which is quite beautiful. I love it, and I cherish it. It's really nice. He's also brought some of his beautiful friends here to meet me and the rest of the community here, and it's lovely. He's really brought a really nice energy here, and it's absolutely wonderful living with him.
I'm Greg Max, and I'm listening to Fierce FM! Woo!
You mentioned the radical fairies during the show, and I've seen you in the kitchen at gatherings, and lots of fairies, I imagine, want to come on the show.
That's right! I'm one of the radical fairies. That's where I got my name, Smiley. I've started the fun with the radical fairies. I started performing and coming out with the radical fairies. I felt so judged before, and it was all coming from me only. And then when I experienced this community, then the whole thing changed, and I started performing from there.
Fairies all over the world.
That's right. We have fairy sanctuaries all over the world. So I would love to keep going. And on the travel, you just get a camera and just film and then bring a recipe or take a recipe, be in the kitchen, cooking together, have like a performance. The whole thing is amazing, isn't it? And also like kids to play in the kitchen instead of just like mom cooking only, you know, they can learn from the beginning. Our first essential is breathing, water, and eat and food. So there's really nothing else, and sleep. So one of the main important things, why we're not doing it in an exciting way, creative way.
So when you're feeling down, do you find the kitchen helps you cheer you up?
What happens sometimes I feel down, and if we do play with it, it can shift it. I usually don't cook when I'm down, because then that energy will go into the food. Then if I eat it, I can get it back. If someone else eat it, it will get it. So I feel like it's good to bring up the mood. I'm trying to put a song that will make me feel different before or while you're preparing, or that will help anyway. Why not? Food can hold the space too.
During the show, we saw you sing love into the food, and that's what you're talking about.
That's right. Just singing. I always love singing. So let's sing more into the food.
Make love into this. So we need to really put a nice song. I will go where you lead. I'll be right there and it ties on me. And when lose my will, fear that push me out that hill. That's no looking back for us. And we got enough to show that's enough. Yo, I mean, yo, I mean, baby.
Thank you.
can be singing, can be dancing. Let's paint in the kitchen while the other one is cooking. Anything that creates happiness. Also, another way is having a thought. Like, I usually think of my niece, and she's 3 years old, and she had that face. So I look at that face and her face, and I feel all beautiful, lighter, like a Peter Pan. Just think of nice thoughts, and I start flying. And then when the magic happens in the food, in the kitchen, yes.
So what's your favorite food?
Oh, I'm Italian. I love pasta. It's one of my favorite things. Let's say the one that you saw on the shows are my favorites. Yeah.
Oh, I've got pasta waiting for me now. Thank you so, so much, Hazelnuts, for a fantastic invitation here for Fierce.
Thank you so much for being here and seeing the show and enjoy. Oh, we have our beautiful dog. Say hi to.
What's your favorite song to cook to?
I love the one about Marley. I wanna love you. Is this love? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling? Yee! Is this love? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling? Yeah.
Thank you.
I want to honour the traditional owners of the lands where you are living. They took care of these lands for thousands and thousands of years and then shared this land with us at great cost to their own lives. I want to thank them for the care they have given and continue to give, to sit on the earth, listen and care for country. I also want to thank the fairies and crones who came before us in history to fight for our human right to love fiercely. Thank you for listening to Fierce. This program celebrates the diversity of LGBTIQ identities and perspectives. Fierce is produced in Bundjalung Country at 2NCR Lismore and can also be heard on podcast at fiercefm.podbean.com and in New Zealand on Fresh FM, as well as all over Australia through the Community Radio Network.
Fierce FM on Spotify.
Thank you, a beautiful mom to Foxy Brown-Eye, a beautiful artist. Look at her on Instagram and on Facebook and on YouTube. And if you want to support us again, we're going to put a little PayPal account in case you want to put something in there for support this cause. We want to have some funds, but they are... How can you say it's not profitable? This is all going to a bigger cause. If you want to know more about it, we'll write it down. I haven't written it down. I'm very like, let's do it like that. So I want to say, and I love you, and have a beautiful time. And yes, it's going to be like a month, more or less, between the first season and the second season. And then more things will come up. So, mwah again, and
mwah again for me.